Hello everyone, in this video we'll talk about sphingolipids and we would try to compare sphingolipids with phospholipids and try to understand the chemical differences and their biological function. Sphingolipids are a class of lipids which has the long chain alcohol which is known as sphingosine. Now, when we talk about fat or lipids, this picture comes in our head. A glycerol moiety along with fatty acid, and fat is nothing but the ester of these two, and these fatty acids could be the unsaturated or the saturated ones depending upon the location that they are found. Now let's talk about phospholipids before we compare phospholipids and sphingolipids such that we get a better understanding in these two. So phospholipids are found in plasma membrane. They have a phosphate head which is hydrophilic and there is a hydrophobic tail. So in the hydrophilic head, the alcohol part is glycerol and there is also a phosphate group attached with the R group. But in case of sphingolipid, the biggest difference is the alcohol part is sphingosine and it's not glycerol. So this is the major difference between a phospholipid and a sphingolipid. If we talk about the sphingolipid or the basic framework of sphingolipid, this is how it looks like. So it would have three components. One is sphingosine, the alcohol part. One is fatty acid, the acid part. So obviously, these are the two components. And the third component is the R group. The arrow is pointing towards the R group. If this particular R group is hydrogen only, then this is known as ceramide. Now, if this R group is glucose, then this particular sphingolipid would be known as cerebroside, and as the name suggests, it would be found in nervous system, especially in the myelin sheath. Then there is sphingomyelin, where the R group is phosphatidylcholine, and this is also considered as a phospholipid, but the difference is it doesn't have the glycerol moiety as the alcohol part. It is generally found in axons and myelin sheath, especially it is enriched in nervous system. So just to give you a quick comparison, phosphatidylcholine, serine or ethanolamine are characteristic phospholipids found in plasma membrane. Now phosphatidylcholine is not very different from a sphingomyelin. The only difference is it has a sphingosine moiety. So this sphingosine moiety makes sphingomyelin very different from phosphatidylcholine. And it is found in axons. Now let us talk about how these sphingolipids are synthesized. Sphingolipids are synthesized from palmitoyl-CoA and L-lysine, and the enzyme serine palmitoyl transferase is the key commitment enzyme in this pathway. And ultimately it forms 3-ketophosphinogenin. And ultimately it leads to formation of ceramides. Ceramide synthesis takes place in the endoplasmic reticulum. Beyond ceramide, the further modifications such as adding of some sugar moieties or other groups that takes place, or let's say addition of phosphatidylcholine group, these kind of things are happening in the Golgi apparatus. So in a combination of Golgi apparatus and endoplasmic reticulum, the synthesis of sphingolipids takes place. Sphingolipids are majorly found in lipid rafts. Lipid rafts are dense portion in the plasma membrane which has wide variety of functions such as signaling function, and they are like islands inside a membrane. So in the lipid rafts, one can generally find sphingolipids and cholesterol in abundance. So in this video, we have covered what are sphingolipids, functions and their locations, and also we talked about the biosynthetic process or biosynthetic pathway of sphingolipid genesis. So I hope this video was useful. If you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And my courses are also present in Unacademy, which is India's biggest learning platform. If you wish to join, you can use my code AP10 to get a 10% discount. Thanks for listening. Do let me know in the comment how you like my video. Thank you.